Woo! An e-scooter! Oh, just another one out of more than 750,000 e-scooters in Germany. But this here is a special one. It is built for kids. Awesome! It is built at home. Even more awesome! It didn't even take a saw, nor glue, nor a welding torch. And it is getting even awesomer. It is just built from standard building parts that can be mail ordered from Infento in the Netherlands. And the awesomest news for those among you who already own the Legion kit from Infento, this e-scooter can be built entirely from the parts that the Legion kit contains. No 3D printed parts needed, no additional Infento parts. All you will still be needing are a standard bicycle brake cable and an extension cable for the throttle cable with a total worth of some $15. The ride looks simple, but nevertheless, there were a few building challenges we have to talk about. Limited part count. The content of parts inside the Legion kit is quite limited. It is tailored around the choice of vehicles for which Infento provides instructions. Each bolt, each fastener, and each profile that runs out forced me to find an alternative building solution. Two steps forward, one step back is a typical pattern while building. This is a much slower and more annoying way to build compared to building from an instruction. Well, drive. Well, with the new impulse motor from Infento 2.0, the accommodation of the drive unit would have been a piece of cake. But the impulse motor from Infento 1.0 works only together with a toothed belt. This belt drive is anything but compact and therefore hard to package on such a small ride. I couldn't put the motor under the footboard of the scooter because the footboard would have been too high above the road. Finally, I had to locate the whole drive unit in the only place that came into question, behind the driver, pointing upwards. Not really beautiful, but it works. Frame stiffness. The aluminium profiles are very stiff, but the Infento plastic connectors are not. The frame of the scooter is an open U shape, and it was really challenging to prevent it from sagging in the middle. When my daughter hops up and down on the footboard, you can see the frame flexing to some extent. And I also encountered a vivid tendency to twisting. The cure for these issues were finally the multiple diagonal struts that arise from the footboard up to the steering column. This all contributes to the quite high net weight of 22 kg in total. The Multijoint Lifehack. The rear frame had to be 4 profiles wide due to the width of the rear wheel. But the footboard was only 3 profiles wide due to the width of the seat pads that I used for the footboard. Connecting these two sections was truly a problem because there is no Infento standard element that can create an offset of half a profile per side, or in other words, 20 millimeters. The solution is a building technique I have never used or seen before, and not even Infento uses it in their models, although it is yet so easy. So here it is. You build in a multi-joint, but just don't install the knurled disc. This effectively creates an offset of exactly 10 millimeters. Use this technique twice in sequence, then you have the 20 millimeter offset you were searching for. Very simple, right? free instruction. I can only encourage you to take a heart to build this e-scooter by yourself. It is so easy. Under this video, you will find a Dropbox link to a free download for my detailed step-by-step building instruction. Every page shows an exploded view how the parts are meant to be bolted together. There is even an illustration for routing the throttle and brake cable and, of course, also a guide where to purchase the two extra bits you will need. Taking it strictly, this scooter must not be driven on public roads in Germany as any other electric Infento ride with e-pulse motor. But hey, without any tweaks on the motor, this e-scooter reaches a maximum speed of 11 km per hour. Not really a matter of concern for anyone. Well, that's it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe for not missing the upcoming videos I have successfully managed to procrastinate so far. See you next time, and until then, happy building!